It's time to talk about mental health with TFM.
Your full name and your title, please.
Yeah, so it's Teri Elizabeth Ellington.
Perfect. All right, Teri, so you are fantastically sponsoring our mental health campaign that we've got running at the moment. Can you tell us why you wanted to get involved and why mental health is so close to your heart?
Yeah, I wanted to get involved because I've personally myself struggled with mental health. I struggled really badly when I was 16 after struggling with agoraphobia and panic attacks and anxiety and separation anxiety. And I know what it's like at kind of such a young age as well, how alone you can feel. At that age, there wasn't a lot of information as there is today, which I'm so grateful for. And because of that, I want to be on board to help raise the awareness.
And the campaign that we've got, It's Time to Talk, is such a good phrase because in the Northeast, sadly, we've got the highest rate of suicide anywhere in the country. And a lot of people struggle to just get over that first step of talking. How was that for you when you first had your struggles? Did you hold it back before you then decided to tell people, or were you comfortable enough to talk about it?
I was finding it very hard to kind of find the words to describe what I was feeling. It happened so quickly, it was literally overnight. I woke up the next day after having a full-blown panic attack, to which the ambulance was called because I thought I was actually having a heart attack. That was how bad it was. And the next day I woke up and I knew there wasn't something right. I couldn't explain it. And the things that I was doing that I used to do before that had become so difficult. So it was so hard to kind of find the words to actually describe how I was feeling, and there wasn't a lot of information, so the only really people that I had to kind of talk to about it was my family, to which I've had a and I'm very grateful that I've had a very understanding and caring family that have understood what I've gone through and what I was going through at the time. So I think it's so important to keep raising the awareness so that if there is somebody out there who can't find the words to describe how they're feeling, that can kind of show this is it, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it's so important that we all talk. We've done stuff with mental health in the past and the response, just like yourself, just there, it's always positive. It's always good to get the message out. Your business that you've got at the moment, is it something that you talk to your staff or your employees about? Is it mental health like one of your main priorities in business?
Yeah, because at the moment, I'm kind of still a one-woman army. So it is, and I think for me, through my social media and through the business's social media, I always try and keep talking about mental health. Along with the watches on the social media side, I was putting kind of little notes next to them, saying things like, you are loved, never give up, because those were the words that I needed to see and those were the words that I needed to hear, which led to the inspiration bracelets. And on the bracelets I had, you are loved, never give up, and that kind of thing, and that's really helped.
And those inspiration bracelets, they've kind of like really taken off and been like an important part of your business. Was it simply just what you've been through that got you to that point of thinking people need to have these little messages and it would be a great idea if there was bracelets going around with them?
Yeah, I mean, because I needed to hear those words and the feedback that I've had from them, some people have purchased them for themselves, but it's been a purchase that's for someone else. And that was the heartfelt for me. That was the kind of, oh, right, this is what I want to do. I think this would be perfect. And it was in the words like, you are loved, that sold out quickly, because you know, when you are feeling in when you feel depressed and when you are struggling, to know that you are loved, I feel, helps massively.
And with you now in this position where you're helping people, even though like you probably don't see it yourself as like you are helping people, but you are, because you're spreading this positivity and you're spreading these messages. Do you think that these bracelets are going to be, well, I don't want to say it, but like a big help to someone who might be struggling and they don't know exactly what to do, they don't know exactly where to go? If someone gives you one of these bracelets, says you are loved, do you think that could be a way of opening the door for them to get in touch with their feelings and talk more?
I hope so, yeah. When I created the Sheba collection, the Sheba collection was named after my dog who helped me get out the house again. I needed a routine. when I was struggling, and I just didn't have one. And I think like a lot of people don't, who are struggling, they're finding it hard to kind of do things every day, and you sort of will lose a routine. And Sheba helped me have a routine and helped me be able to get out the house again. So that was why I named that first collection after her. And from that, that's kind of, I still want to keep putting the message through the brand, because I'm I still now today receive so many messages, you know, saying I've purchased this because it is, I'm giving it to my relative, or I'm giving it to my friend or my mother or my father, because they're going to see it, read your story, and it's going to help them, inspire them.
I can speak to your former self all those years ago, and now that you've been through everything and you're out on the other end, what would you say to yourself?
I often think about this, if I was back to being 16, and it's to take a day at a time, and it's that it's not going to last. When you are in that position where you are struggling every single day, every day is exhausting, you are literally fighting with your own mind, and it has an actual physical effect on you. And when you are in that frame of mind, and when you are in that position, you generally feel that there is no way out. You do generally feel like, can I cope with this? What is my next move? Where do I go from there? And it would be to just take every day as it comes and to try and talk about it.
Well, me and you having this conversation can help just one person feel that they can talk about it and come through. That's absolutely brilliant. Hopefully will help a lot more people. If there is someone struggling out there who's listening to our interview or watching our interview, what would you want to say to them?
I just want to like to say, and I'm saying this as if I was speaking back to my, you know, myself when I was 16, if there's of any age really, is that to try and, I know it's so difficult, but to try and stay positive, and I know what it's like when you can't, and you generally feel that there's no way out when you're struggling, you know, whether that be from anxiety, panic attacks, depression, or if you like me, you struggle with all of it, is that to try and talk to somebody about it. There is so much help out there now, and so many people are talking about it, that it's turned now into a positive. And I feel that if people can go to the doctors or they can speak to their family members, it will really, really help.
And lastly, I know we spoke about this very at the start, about the actual campaign itself. How proud are you that you're able to get involved in a campaign like what we're running at the moment?
I'm very proud. When I was 16 and I was struggling, I didn't think that I'd be where I am today, doing what I'm doing, openly talking about mental health. I remember the first time that I spoke about it publicly, and it was a news article back in 2018. I was terrified. I was shaking with it coming out, because I didn't know what the kind of response would be. And it's been such a positive response that I've tried to continue talking about it to help raise awareness. So I'm very, very proud.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, Teri. That was brilliant.
Thank you.
It's time to talk about mental health with TFM.